Okay. Hello, everyone. So I am Shinwala and I am from Digit Insurance and I'm your host for today. And I'm presenting to you our first Chai Time with Digit session in collaboration with MFine. Chai Time with Digit is an initiative to open up two-way conversations about positivity during these uncertain times. So in this first session, we will be talking about mental health during COVID times, honoring the Mental Health Awareness Month. All of us have been extremely anxious and, dealing with the constant fear of us or our family members contracting the virus. In such times, it is gradually becoming difficult to lead a normal life. Hence, the need to talk about mental health and well-being is the most now more than ever. So we have a very special guest with us today, joining us in this session, who would share insights and expert opinion on how to boost mental health and well-being in such times. We have Ms. Dipanitha Roy, consultant clinical psychologist at MFine. Hi, Dipanitha. Welcome to the Chai Time with Digit session. Thank you so
Hi.
much for joining us today amidst your busy schedule. Hope you're doing well and you and your family are safe.
Absolutely.
Great.
Thank you.
So,
Thank you for
Dipanitha,
having
starting
me
off.
today.
Yeah, Dipanitha, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Great. So, Dipanitha, starting off with the session directly, I'm sure according to your experience, clients come to you talking about, increased anxiety, stress, panic in today's times. And with so much going around, especially negative news, there's always this fear that's lurking around. You must have heard people saying that, I feel anxious about catching the virus or transmitting it to a loved one. In such a case, how can one break the cycle of anxiety and fear?
Absolutely, absolutely. So first of all, Shubhila, thank you for having me for today's session. I really appreciate it. And anyone who is joining us here today, and I hope that you all are staying safe, taking care of yourself, staying at home, and you're just being and hanging in there in this entire process, right? So to come into the question, the first thing that I would suggest that, of course, like you have said, that you have correctly mentioned it, that there's so much of lurking around happening between the anxiety and stress. I think the first thing that we need to be aware about that we can only take care of someone else. It could be our family, it could be our spouse, it could be a friend also. Only and only if we are taking care of ourselves, right? So first and foremost, we have to
Absolutely, absolutely.
ensure that we are taking care of ourselves, and that's the reason, and that's the only way we will be able to take care of others in the process, right? So firstly, be
True.
informed. We need to be informed of whatever, like how it's happening. We know the protocols, everything that's happening. We are already aware about it. But at the same time, it's also important that we are rightly informed and we are not being over-informed, right? I think with the second wave
Right,
of
right.
pandemic coming up, we have seen that there's an overload of information all across social media. We live in a digital society and we cannot absolutely avoid these informations, but it's important that we are relying on the verified sources, and also we are also verifying them before we are actually sharing it to the group, right? And the way
Absolutely,
to
absolutely.
manage anxiety would be that try to limit how often you are checking on these updates. Right, if throughout the day or from the morning to the night, if you occupy yourself with so much of information overload, that will in turn will add up to your anxiety and stress. Right?
Right.
Absolutely. And whatever, whenever you have a doubt, experts are always a better go out rather than looking out for anybody else.
True, true. So very rightly said, Dipanitha. I think absolutely we are overburdening ourselves with so much information that it occupies our entire day. But also,
Absolutely.
Dipanitha, in with the second wave coming in, we do hear a lot of near and dear ones contracting the virus. And once somebody has tested positive, there is generally a level of panic that comes with it, right? But we also see that experts and doctors, across the globe has said if we start panicking, it will definitely hinder the rate of recovery. So in such a case, how can somebody stay positive if they themselves have tested positive?
Absolutely. Yeah. So the first thing that I would say that whether you have tested positive or you are still waiting for your reports to come, because of course with the second wave it sometimes takes more than 2 to 3 days to actually get the report. First thing is, of course, the only way to stop the virus from spreading is that you actually isolate yourself. So goes without saying that you are isolating yourself. And the very next thing would be that only think about that, what are the things that are under your control, right? So there's only a certain amount of things right. that you can control by yourself, and whatever the rest of the things are, whatever that's there, either you leave it or you accept things which aren't under your control, right? And also simultaneously right. it's extremely important that you are sticking to your doctor's advice, right? At this point of time you might have a lot of well-wishers coming across you and giving you their advices, and which of course we need to take up with a pinch of salt. But when it comes to your own health, when it comes to your own mental health also, like I said, don't overboard yourself with so much of information. So stick to your doctor's advice, and as much as is possible, stay connected, right? Even if you are isolated with your family member, or they are maybe on the next room with you, instead of just waiting for that person to call you up, maybe you initiate a video call or a voice call to that person and just talk, right? So even if the physical distance right. we cannot minimize, the more we stay socially connected, the better we will be fighting the virus. And that would automatically have a lot of positive impacts on our mind, right? Because when we are stressed, even it's not just the virus on our body, but somewhere our neurotransmitters, our hormones are also acting up, right? So we have to also ensure that we are taking care of those things as well.
Sure. So that was necessarily my next question as well, that, you know, we've mm-hmm. been mostly at home since the last year, as it is the necessary thing to do. And we have not met our family or friends or colleagues for a long time. So in such a case, as you rightly said, it also brings you know, a feeling of despair, loneliness, isolation. Mm-hmm. Similarly, if I have tested positive and I have to quarantine myself for at least, like, you know, 2 to 3 mm-hmm. weeks, it takes a huge toll on my mental health, well-being as well, right? Also with the entire stigma going around with COVID recovered patients, they somewhere feel socially excluded and isolated. So in such mm-hmm. times, in both cases, if you have not tested positive but you're anxious, and as well as if you have tested positive and are in quarantine, how do you maintain that sanity for that longer period of time?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. See, yes, of course, like when you are tested positive and you are in isolation, so it's not that, of course, we have been staying at home for quite some time now, right? We are all find our own ways of dealing with things. It's not that we are not coping up. All of us have find out our own way of coping with things, right? But when you are actually tested positive and when you are in isolation, the fear gets into you. Right. So I was discussing this, and I have been very vocal about this also, that even being a mental health professional, I was tested positive and I have seen that so much of ups and downs that goes into it. Even when I know that at that point of time that I, no matter what it is, no matter how I'm trying to stay positive, the anxiety will automatically hit you. Right? Because it's something extremely novel to you. Right? It's something that you are completely not aware about at that point of time. Right? So that is Absolutely. The main reason why yeah. it's also very important that stay away from all the negativities. That's something that has really worked out for me. The more you limit your social media access, or it's the right time for you to take a digital detox maybe for yourself. Step aside from whatever that hampers with your mental health, and rather start exploring and try things that you might be waiting for quite a long period of time to try for yourself. Maybe this is the right time for you to try that, right? And at the same time, yeah, this is something right. I have experienced myself, that do not push yourself. Right. So I remember during the first 1 or 2 days of time, I thought that, okay, I'll continue working. Anyways, I'm working from home. Now I'm inside the home, so I will be able to manage my work. Right. But I have seen that the moment I tried to pushing myself, it hit me bad. Right. Because my body was not being able to accustom to it, or the load which I can take for myself, I could not take that. Right. So it's very important that, of course, doctors are saying it outright and every time that you have to ensure that you are taking care of your health, you have to ensure that you are popping your pills. All of these things are fine, but make sure that you are getting the adequate amount of rest also. Right. Eat well. And of course, at the same time, sleep well. At least 6 to 8 hours of sleep, which is absolutely essential for you, and you cannot compromise on that. Right, and like I said, that stay connected. That at this point of time, when you are isolated alone, maybe your near ones and your close ones are more worried about you than you being inside the room, right? So, the more you stay connected to these people, the more you talk to them, the better you would feel for yourself also, and they will also eventually feel much more safe.
Absolutely, absolutely right. Absolutely correct, Dipanatha. Like you said, it is the right time to take a digital detox and, explore other things that we have always wanted to do. Probably like this is the time we should, take a step back from overload of social media and explore something that would help us rather, stay afloat. So my next
Absolutely.
question, Dipanatha, would be, we've heard that COVID also has neurological imbalances and it has some long-term effects. So with respect to mental health, what do you think, does it portray any long-term mental health issues after recovery?
Okay. Yes. So primarily what I would say that COVID anxiety is something which is real, and that is something will definitely stay with you even after you are on your recovery. Right? So what is anxiety? So if I have to even further simplify it for you, anxiety is nothing but our body's reaction to stress. Right? So stress is something which is inevitable, be it in terms of our relationships or our work. It at this point of time, it could also be a diagnosis of testing positive, right? Irrespective of that, even when you have recovered from COVID and you are doing fairly fine, but the anxiety that associated with it, the palpitations or the chest tightness, the sweating, increased sweating, or the heart rate going ups and downs. I interact quite a lot with so many people that they keep on saying that even when they have recovered from COVID, they keep on checking their oxygen saturation. Like they told me that it has never gone down below 99, but that anxiety of it, what if it goes down? Right, because so many a times continuously we are bombarded with this information that it should not never go down below 94, right? So that is why people are so concerned about keep on checking them. They check on their temperature. Maybe it's not even going up. They know that they are not having any fever, but those are the anxiety responses that stays with it. And additionally, other than these, COVID has also triggering all the existing or the past mental health issues that somebody might have been experienced in the past, right? So let's say somebody, if they have been diagnosed with depression, clinical depression or anxiety or any other diagnosis for that matter, and maybe they're in their recovery phase, but with COVID taking place, we have seen that there's been a relapse on their symptoms. Right. In such cases, the moment you, the only solution to it would be to look out for the warning signs. Right. So, what are the warning signs that how much it has been affecting your sleep patterns, your eating habits, and also your overall energy level? Right. So, look out for these symptoms if you witness any mood changes or any symptoms that you feel that it's a little unusual than your regular behaviors, then it's always a good idea to get in touch with a mental health professional. You can talk to your psychiatrist, you can talk to your psychologist, and we are more than willing to help you out through this process.
Right, absolutely. So I think that's a very valid point. I mean, I have personally seen a lot of people going through COVID anxiety. And as you rightly said, sometimes we don't understand that our sleeping patterns or our energy levels are directly related to our mental health issues. So
Absolutely.
we are always, assuming that it is maybe because of an underlying disease. However, many a times it has been that it is due to depression, clinical depression. I would like tell
Absolutely.
you one example. Like my father had recovered from COVID, and he continuously had low energy levels. So then we went to all sorts of doctors and we got him checked, but nothing came out as an underlying disease. disease. And then the doctor asked us to take him to a mental health personal because we had to get him checked for depression. So, you know, it is so prevalent, yet so people are so unaware about it. So I think it's a very, very relevant point. And as you said, the warning signs are something which can be as simple as people not feeling like feeling hungry, or people are not, you know, getting enough sleep, and that should not be taken lightly, even from a mental health angle.
So whenever we are talking about mental health, like, this is something which I keep repeating every now and then, that your mental health is as important as your physical health, right? Many a times, as physically we are fit, we take care of our health, we ensure that we are eating well, we are ensuring that we are sleeping well also. But sometimes the same way, if we feel angry or we feel anxious, we feel we are in despair, we often feel that we often blame it to the external situation, right? So maybe I'm angry with so much of work that's happening around. Maybe I'm anxious of what am I going to do next, right? But these are the things that will also in return will impact your eating habits and your sleeping patterns, right? So both of these things goes hand in hand. There's no second doubt about it. So the more we are being aware about it, the more we'll be able to identify it at the right time and accordingly take the next step forward.
True, absolutely. I think, that's a very valid point. So, Dipanitha, I think overall, this has been one of the most difficult times that we've faced in years, right? Absolutely. So, how do you suggest somebody to maintain their sanity and their, you know, level head to go ahead with their daily lives? Because, you know, I was just reading it somewhere that we are in so much anxiety, and there's a word apparently which is called languishing, which feels like, you know, there is nothing in front of me. It's a void, it's an emptiness, and I have nothing forward to look forward. So in such a case, with so many negative emotions, how do you, again, overall, how do you suggest somebody to go ahead with their day-to-day life?
Absolutely. So the first thing that I would say, that the same way, think about the time. Like, I think it's not just for us, our generation, even our parents must have witnessed something so severe in their lifetime, right? So it's something that we are, and even in terms of the amounts of loss that we are seeing in this particular year, right? So many people are suffering, either losing someone close to them or someone they know distantly, right? So it's a mass grief that we are experiencing. So like you said, that even if the tomorrow doesn't look very fluid and better for ourselves, first we need to ensure that we are taking care of ourselves today, right? So in a similar manner, the first thing would be that routine and having a discipline. Like, that's the same way, think about it, when you used to go to your office, so you would always have a designated time for everything, right? So the same thing, which since we are working from home, somewhere we are working with home also, we are not being, there's no balance, there's absolutely zero balance of how we are distinguishing between our work and between our personal life, right? But the same way, when it comes to taking care of ourselves, make sure that you are having a designated time for everything, right? So when it comes to your work, when it comes to your personal time, when it comes to your couple time or your family time, everything should have a designated time for yourself. And at the same time, at least take out 30 minutes of your day. 30 minutes is something that easily any one of us can take out from their schedule. Take those 30 minutes out and make sure that you do something which you feel like, that's something you enjoy. And the more and more you enhance those activities and you continue on doing that, the better you will be able to sustain in the long run.
Right. Yeah, so that sounds really well, actually. I think I am also going to do it, because as you rightly said, 30 minutes is something we can definitely take out. I think most of us spend that 30 minutes looking at the news and, you know, looking at social media and, you know, again, moving back to that cycle of anxiety and fear. So instead of that, yeah, maybe we can just take a step back and do whatever we would want, or whatever can give us a positive approach. Definitely. Absolutely. So, Dipanmita, I think it has been a really insightful session. Before concluding it, I was just talking to you and you told me mm-hmm. that you have recently recovered from COVID yourself. So, yes. if it is fine and if you're comfortable, can you mm-hmm. just share your experience? I mean, you being a mental health personal, how did you cope up with it? Did you go through the entire phase of, you know, like how we were discussing anxiety, fear, all of those phases, and then there, how did you take a step back and, you know, overcome that, overcome the quarantine and came out stronger? So if you can just share your experience with us.
Yes, yes. So firstly, what I would say that I think I was lucky enough to be being in isolation with someone else, right? I think that has been a privilege, and also having a strong support system, like that is something which is extremely important at that point of time. That's the first thing that came to me, that I'm sitting at home, I'm isolated, I cannot step out of the room, but I have somebody to look after my food, and there's somebody to look after the house, and there's somebody to actually deliver the medicines at my doorstep, right? Because at this point right. of time, I have actually seen so many people not having those facilities as well, which can be really right. traumatic and really saddening as well. So that definitely right. is something I would say that I had the privilege of. But like I said, that the few things that kept me going during those 3 weeks of time, I would say that sticking to your doctor's advice, like no matter what you are saying, there were a lot of people calling me up, a lot of colleagues that were calling me up and suggesting a lot of things. But it's always a good idea that you stick to your doctor's advice and as much as it's possible, like the same way, the routine also, which I was saying, even when I was stuck inside the room, I was not working. I was taking that time that there used to be a routine that when I was doing steam inhalation or gargling, all of these was a part of the routine. So that way, it was not that something I was only lying on bed. So I knew that these are the things I also need to make sure that is happening and I'm taking care of it. Other than that, I would say that I did meditation for a long time. Like there are apps like Headspace, Calm. I used them quite a lot. And I make sure that at least for 10 to 15 minutes, I'm sparing that time out and I'm doing some meditation. And also, like I said, let's stay connected. Even when my parents were right down to the next room, I made sure to call them out, right? Make a video call at least once a day and let them know that, hey, I'm doing fine. Because from the outside, all they can hear is me coughing. Right. So that can be very anxiety provoking, not just for me, but for them as well, as a caregiver.
Absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
So absolutely. The more you stay connected, the more you let them know of how you are feeling and how things are shaping up for you, the better they are going to feel. Right. And additionally, like this is something that my doctor recommended, that whenever you are having temperature, whatever the symptoms that you are having in terms of oximeter and all of those things, make a note of it. Keep a journal to yourself and make a note of how things are shaping up for you. So I did the same thing for my mental health also. So I made it a point that each day, as and when I was passing the each day, I made sure to write one or two pointers in it, that how am I feeling today? How I'm actually feeling today? Am I anxious? Am I sad? Am I I'm feeling angry? Of course, there's a time I felt extremely angry, that when can I step out of the room? But at the same time, I took the time. I think it was a good break, I would say, but not the best break that I would expect from me. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of pain also. But other than that, like, it has been a challenging time. But the only way to stay positive is, like I said, that going on a digital detox. I explored. I used to draw a lot. I used to read a lot. Whatever, like random. I never drew in my life. So it used to be just random scribbling. But I made sure that I am doing it. So whatever it takes for you to take care of yourself, you have to ensure that.
Absolutely, absolutely. So summarizing the session, I think what we all learned today was stay connected. Don't wait for people to call you. You can take the first step and call them. Even for your caregivers, even for family and friends who are staying away, please do call them and check up on them and let them know that you're doing okay. Take a digital detox, take a step back, explore something that you might not have gotten the time before this to explore. Like, you know, the Panita started drawing. So similarly, you know, you do something that you always wanted to do and something that makes you feel good. Don't overboard yourself with too much information. Yes, information is good. We definitely, you know, should have the right sources, but make sure that you're only and only following genuine and authentic sources. And also, you know, according, like I also used to do it a lot, that I would keep checking the numbers every day, and I know, you know, I would keep seeing where India is and what are the daily numbers. I mean, yes, from information point of view, it is okay, but it does take a lot of toll on your mental health as well. So if you feel that, you know, for some time you should stop doing that, go ahead and, you know, do not look at the numbers on a daily basis. Also, very, very rightly said, be very kind to yourself, because this is one of the most difficult times that not only we, but even our parents are, you know, experiencing. So in such a time, I think the best way for it is to take one day at a time and see how we are doing, you know, in that day, and then think about what to do tomorrow or how would tomorrow look. Like you were also saying, Dipanita, correctly, like we should take care of ourselves today first and then think about how will tomorrow shape up. Right. Absolutely. And in terms of, you know, if you've tested positive, then stay connected again. Maintain a journal. Very nice, you know, suggestion. You know, maintain a journal of how you're feeling every day. And it would definitely help you in understanding how you are placed in terms of your mental health. After you've recovered, if you see the warning signs, like, you know, not sleeping enough, not feeling hungry, your energy levels are extremely low, please do not hesitate to talk to a mental health professional, because there are chances that if you have been diagnosed with any previous mental health issue, it might reoccur, and it is normal. So you can just go ahead and talk to your mental health professional. Even if you are feeling COVID anxiety, which is also very real, like Dipanita was saying, where, you know, you keep checking your temperature, you keep checking your saturation levels, at some point it might not be very normal. So in that case also, if you need help, please do not hesitate to talk to a therapist or to a psychologist. Please go ahead and take help. Overall, I would say that you know, yes, this is a difficult time, but all is not lost. We will come out stronger in this. So stay at home, wear your mask, get vaccinated whenever you can, and keep doing things which you would also do previously, instead of just thinking about COVID overall. Yes, we are in a very difficult spot. We are hearing, you know, grim news every time. Many of us are losing our loved ones. It's absolutely, I mean, devastating and saddening. However, the only way to move ahead is have a positive approach and, you know, maintain a routine. You know, keep doing more things as well. And yeah, we're all in this together, and we will come out stronger. So thank you so much, Dipanita. I think all of us have learned so much today. I personally am going to apply all of these insights to my life and, you know, break this cycle of anxiety and negativity, so that we can move ahead and, you know, come out stronger and have a positive approach towards life. Thank you again. Thank you everyone for joining us. Hopefully this session could help in clearing your doubts and questions that has been lurking in all of our minds. And as I said, we just need to remember, we will fight this and we'll come out stronger. Stay safe, wear your mask, get vaccinated. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.